Welcome back to the Narrowbone channel. This is a review of the SV Boney dew heater strap. This one is USB powered. There's a lot of these USB powered dew heater straps kind of starting to show up in the market, and they're very affordable. I'm going to give you my thoughts in detail about this guy, but I'll also tell you some things about some of the other ones that I've seen and tested, and also some of my thoughts on the dew heater straps that have been around for 40 plus years. They're quite expensive, the ones that have been around for a long time, and are they really worth the extra cost? I'll answer that. Now you may be wondering to yourself, okay, well, what do you need a dew heater for? Essentially, a dew heater is going to wrap around the lens and it's going to provide some heat to your optical system, essentially. And this is a good kind of heat because it's going to keep moisture from settling and condensing on your equipment. Now, typically, when you have a lens shade like this one, if you're shooting objects like this, this is not a huge consideration, okay, because dew settles downwards. However, when you're pointing up at the sky, well, then it's going to basically miss your lens shade, essentially. And I know recently I was running four cameras one night and I only had three dew straps that I could use. And so this guy here, I ran without a dew heater and I only got five good subs out of the thing, even though I had the lens shade extended. And what's great about a dew heater is that it means that you can shoot kind of all night long, even on a very hot and humid night in the summertime, and you don't have to worry about dew. Now, SV Boney sells three different sizes. This is the shortest one that they sell, and this is the longest one that they sell. This is 40 centimeters. I think this is 25. And the 25, I bought this one to use on my guide scope. And I kind of wish that there was even a shorter option out there. SV Boney, I'm sure you're watching this. If you guys could come out with an even smaller one, something maybe that's 20 centimeters long or 18 centimeters long, I think that would work well for like your 30 millimeter F4 guide scopes that are very, very popular right now. And then the longer one, I know I have an 8-inch Newtonian. It would be nice if there was a longer one out there. This guy here will fit a scope all the way up to about 120 millimeters objective. So once you get to like the 8-inch or the 10-inch or the 12-inch objectives, you're probably going to need to buy two of these and kind of daisy chain them together, kind of like that, okay, in order to get them to go around. Well, actually, you'd want to overlap the heating portion like so, and that way you can get these onto an even bigger optical system. So you have the option to work with it. Just, it would be nicer if there was a bigger one out there. That's really, yeah, my only complaint is that there aren't more choices available to me. So the SV Boney model that I have in particular, it comes with this. This is a bit of an extender, and it has basically built into it a controller that allows you to increase and decrease the amount of voltage that's being put in producing heat in your optical system. And it's kind of nice that it is a separate component because you can remove it if you need to. I know my ASI Air Pro that I run mine with has its own controller built into it, so it's not, may not be necessary for your system. Now, one thing that would be nice is that these two USB interfaces locked together, but you can always just tape them together, and that's an easy solution for that. Another great thing about these things being USB powered is that it's, I think, 5 volts, 1.2 amps, and pretty much any cell phone booster or charger is going to work with these. And that's kind of one of the reasons why I think they're getting popular, is because, you know, you can take one of these with you and just, I don't know, Velcro it to maybe your tripod or something like that, and then you have, you know, portable power. Now, let me show you how this kind of goes on here. So it would wrap around the optical system like so. And this is where I like this part right here, is that I can like kind of extend this and it gives you a lot of tension around the lens. And tension is good. You want a lot of good compression here because the more compressed this is on the lens, the more efficient the heat transfer is going to be to the lens. And that means you're going to need less power. And if you're running off batteries and you're at a remote location, using less power is always a good thing. Now, another option that you have, this is a USB female, okay, to DC port. And these are great if you have something like, this is an ASI Air. So ASI Air, they have these different ports here, and you would not want to run this at full power. Each of these ports can be the amperage of them can be turned down, which you will want to turn them down, because one time I was using another dew heater strap and I melted it along with a lens. But with something like this, this would give you the option of, you know, plugging into an ASI Air Pro like this guy right here. Or you could even find the appropriate voltage and amperage power supply and just plug it in directly, maybe to an AC outlet or something like that. So that's kind of another nice little thing about the USB, and that the USB bus is such a universal thing. There's so many accessories out there for it. That's kind of what makes these things so, you know, accessible to everybody, so to speak. Now, this right here, this is another one that's out there, and this is actually one I melted, and it still works though, which is kind of surprising. But what I don't like about this is that the stretchiness of it, you know, there really isn't very much stretchiness to it, and the Velcro that's right here, it doesn't secure very well, okay? And I know SV Boney actually sells one very similar to this. I think it's a little bit wider. I haven't tried it myself personally, but if it was me, the one with the orange elastic strap on it, this is the one that I would go for, because I've found this one to work great. You know, the stitching on it's a little bit sloppy, but you know, it works fantastic for what it does. Now, some last thoughts. So I'm not going to name the other brands out there, but there's some brands of dew heaters that have been around on the market for a very, very long time. All right, so I'm here at Naylor Observatory. This is in Harrisburg. This is one of our 14-inch Meads. It's an LX200. And this guy, we actually do occultation studies with these telescopes. And of course, with a big front objective like this that's not protected at all, dew heaters are very important. So one of the things that we do to kind of increase dew heater efficiency is we actually have insulated straps that go around the straps themselves. And then as you can see on here, we've got actually four straps on this guy, two side by side and two daisy chained together. And then of course, down here is where they're connected. Now, these dew heaters, I mean, they have lots of cool features and stuff, but they cost a premium, okay? In my opinion, they cost a little more than I think they should. You know, they use old plugs that are basically look like they're from an old stereo system to a radio. You know, I know maybe that was the only option they had back then, but you know, this is 2020. I think it's time to upgrade. So those are my thoughts on some of the more expensive ones that are out there. Now, one more thing. One nice thing about this Siboney, and this is kind of something to look for, is that this is a 22 gauge wire that they have in here. The competing one that I have here, this is a ProTag, and this has a 24 gauge, which is one gauge thinner wire. So this is not going to handle as much power as this guy does. So those are kind of my thoughts. Hope you found that helpful. Maybe it will give you some ideas on different ways that you can connect yours up to your equipment. I know I really like these things. I've actually ordered two more and they'll be here soon.